गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, दिस वीडियो फॉर क्लास 10 स्टूडेंट. स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव कवर्ड बेसिकली चैप्टर नंबर 1, चैप्टर नंबर 2, चैप्टर नंबर 3 एंड चैप्टर नंबर 4 एंड फिफ्थ चैप्टर इट वॉज गोइंग ऑन. दैट इज़ द वर्ड प्रॉब्लम, लास्ट टॉपिक इट इज़ गोइंग ऑन फॉर द फिफ्थ चैप्टर. बट एज पर द डिमांड ऑफ सम ऑफ द स्टूडेंट, दे वर नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ GST. सो टूडे आई वॉन्ट टू टेक this video for them only so they can understand the idea of GST. So first of all, whenever you find a question from GST, you should have an idea what is the meaning of GST. GST means tax. If your transaction is intrastate, intrastate means transaction in a same state, means if you are in Uttaranchal and if all the transactions are made in this Uttaranchal only, then you should apply the concept of GST. But if you transfer your business one state to another state, then it is called IGST. Full form of IGST is Integrated Goods and Service Tax. It is Goods and Service Tax. Basically, this GST is divided into two parts. One tax, it has to go to the state government, and another tax has to go to the central government. Means if you say GST, it means state government tax plus central government tax. If you say SGST only, so means only state tax. If you say only CGST, it means only central government tax. But overall it is called GST. So it depends on questions whether they are asking SGST, they are asking CGST, or they are asking only GST. It depends on the question. But one more thing, it has to be clear that transaction is in the same state, means it is intrastate or interstate. Interstate and intrastate, it is mentioned in question. If the transaction is going on from one state to another state, it is called interstate. If transaction is going on in one state only, means only and only one state is involving, then it is called intrastate. So this policy you have to understand first before starting the questions. So you should note down this part. So one of the example I will give, through which I am trying my best to make you understand how to calculate GST in a particular question. So student, look at this question. In this question, we have one of the manufacturer. He is selling an article to the dealer A by this amount to 25,000 rupees. Means cost price for this person is 25,000. Now he is selling to B at a profit of 3,000. Means his CP is 25,000. But when he is selling this article to B, 3,000 is profit. So you can say it is 28,000 basically, isn't it? Now this 28,000 is a cost price for this B, and he is selling to the consumer at a profit of 2,000. So this B and C, 30,000 will be the transaction amount over here. Now look at the question. The question is, we have to find the amount of GST paid by A. Now look at here. A is not a consumer basically. He is a businessman. So he has to face two steps. One is input and another is called output. When he is purchasing, it is called input tax. When he is selling the article, then it is called output tax. So what you have to do, first you find input GST for A. So you know, input GST means CGST plus SGST. So you should know the rate of GST, it is given 10%. So I can say 5% for CGST. So 25,000 into 5/100, and SGST is 25,000 into 5/100. So this takes for this one. So here you cancel out two zeros. So definitely, and same calculation it will also give. So it is 0, 0 and 2500 is the final input input GST. Now output GST. For A, it is basically CGST plus SGST. Now you see, he is selling the article to 28,000. It is 28,000. So 28,000 multiplied by 5 by 100, and here 28,000 into 5 by 100, it has to go for this part. Two zeros are cancelled out, so it will give 5 into 40, carry 4, 1400. Second is also 1400. So 2800 is the output GST. Now net GST is basically output minus input. So it is 2800 minus 2500. So only 300 rupees he has to pay for GST to the government of India, because he made the business against his business. He has to pay 300 rupees, and this is the answer of first part. So that was the question, amount of GST paid by A. Now I want to start the second part of this question. Look at once more. This is the last step. Now look at the second part. Second part, they have asked amount paid by consumer inclusive GST, because consumer is not making any business over here. So he has to just give this cost price plus tax. So I have written here amount paid by consumer is equal to cost price plus CGST plus SGST. So cost price is 30,000 rupees. CGST is, because it is 10%, so 5% he has to go for central and 5% for state. So 1500 plus 1500, that is 3000 rupees is the tax, and 33,000 is the final answer for this question. So student, take the hint from these questions. Soon I will give one more questions. I will take the questions from your book, but the basic idea is this much only. So try to grab this concept. I will give one more video for this GST also, for making it clear. And from your book questions I will take. So take the hint from these questions. Thank you.